As-salamu alaykum. Today I will be showing you how to add the Hijri calendar to your Windows 10 PCs. Perhaps your workplace has required you to follow the Hijri calendar, or perhaps it's your own personal preference to follow this beautiful calendar of ours. And in either cases, I will give you two ways of having the Hijri calendar implemented on your Windows PC without any additional software needed. So, let's begin. The first step is to go on the Start menu. Click on your calendar application, maybe in the Start menu. And you're presented with the default Windows 10 calendar. As we can see, it is showing us the Gregorian dates. And we want to see the Hijri calendar dates as well. It's a very easy process. You simply click on the wheel over here, the settings menu, settings wheel. You go on calendar settings, scroll down, and you're presented with this section called alternate calendars. Simply click on enable and click on the Gregorian, click on Hijri, and there you go. You have the Hijri calendar right next to the Gregorian dates. So at my location, it's 30th Muharram, 1443, 21st August, 2021. This is correct. So for me, this works just fine the way it is. However, maybe in your location, the moon sighting was at a different date. And this is showing you the Hijri date that is 1 or 2 days ahead or behind. It's very easy to calibrate this and fix it. You just click on the settings again over here, go on calendar settings, scroll down. Here you have the offset value option. Simply click on it and you can choose if you want to make the date be a day ahead or two or a day behind or so. So for example, if at my location it's supposed to be 12th Muharram, I can simply click -1 and we can see it has changed to 12th. And all the other dates ahead of this have calibrated themselves to adjust to this new setting of yours. It's a very streamlined function and is very useful for those who want to maybe adjust it. So for me, it was perfectly fine at 0. So now it has readjusted back to what it was, and it's that easy. For me, by my personal experience, leaving it at 0 has been always correct, but you know, depending on your region, perhaps this may not always be accurate. So the second way of doing this is to change the system date and time to be the Hijri date itself. So what I'm trying to say is, if you click over here on your date, you can see this is showing Gregorian dates over here. It's showing Gregorian date beneath the time as well. It's showing the Gregorian date over here. Even your widget of this calendar is showing the Gregorian date. We can change all of this to Hijri with a few clicks, and just follow through as to what I'm doing, and inshallah, you will also be able to have Hijri calendar as your system date. All you do is right click over here on the date, click adjust date and time, go on this related settings, date, time, and regional formatting, and we are now at a place where we can now play around with the regional format data, which is what we want to do. So the top setting will stay as whatever country or region you are in. You can change it to whichever one you want. It's best to leave it to where you're currently living. However, it's the regional format setting which we can play around with. Simply click here. Click on Arabic Saudi Arabia. And we noticed a lot of things just changed. And that's perfectly normal. Just bear with me. We can change it to whatever format you like. So over here, if you click, we can see this is written in Arabic script. If you are comfortable with this, then alhamdulillah for you. You are already through the entire process and you have the Hijri calendar as a system date and time. However, for some of us, maybe we do not know how to read Arabic script and we want to change this to the Arabic numerals we have in English. So all you do is click over here, additional date, time, and regional settings. Click here to change date, time, or number formats. And over here, we go on additional settings. Now, this is where we can format it to whatever format we prefer. So the standard digits, you can change it to the ones we recognize. So in my case, I recognize the Arabic numerals, which we have in English, as the one which I'm most familiar with. So I click on it. Use native digits. Make sure you change this to never. This is very important. Don't keep it in context. Change it to never. I think even national works, but just for the sake of simplicity, let's just click never. So this as the Arabic numerals in English, native digits as never, hit apply, and there you go. You already have the entire Hijri date written in English in Arabic numerals. So we are on the 13th Muharram 1443, and it's a Saturday. The last step is to format this in a way that we prefer, and it's very easy to do. Simply go to your currency, change it back to dollars or euros, whichever one you had before. For me, it's dollars. You go on time, click on AM, change it to AM, PM, change it to PM, hit apply, and there you go. You have the time with the AM, PM, as we know in English, and we have the Hijri dates written in Arabic numerals the way we read in English as well. There's a last step which I do want to make mention of. There are two steps, actually. You can change the first day of the week to whatever you prefer. You can change it to Friday, Saturday. It's up to you. One thing you should do is click on calendar type and select the second option where it says Hijri over here at the end. Now, the reason why I'm mentioning this is once you click it, you get this additional setting called Adjust the Hijri Date. And this is important because you can adjust it to however you have it in your local area. So like we mentioned earlier, if it's maybe 12th Muharram instead of 13th, for me, I could click on 12th, hit apply, and you would have 12th, normally speaking, if I hit apply. Yeah, there we go. It's 12th Muharram on a Saturday, which is not the case for me. It may be for you, and whichever dates you have, simply go back to the default one is the center one usually. So I do have 13th Muharram today in my location, so I'll leave it at that. And here you go, it's back to the calendar settings as we preferred. Hit OK, hit apply, OK, close, and there you have it. You have the Hijri calendar as a system date and time. Just keep in mind of two things. Firstly, that this is going to be written right to left because that's how Arabic is written. So it may seem annoying at the start, but trust me, once you follow the Hijri calendar solely on your Windows PC, this is not an issue because Arabic is written right to left instead of left to right. And having like Muharram written here in Arabic, it I guess would be difficult for them to have it written the other way around. But just to let you know, just to keep in mind so that you do not get confused, it is going right to left. Another thing as a closing statement I can mention is your calendar app will change as well. If you click on it, you will be met with this screen where you now have the Hijri date as a primary date. And since we've changed it to the secondary date as Hijri as well, we have double Hijri dates showing up. So you just go to calendar settings, you can change it off, and there you go. You have the Hijri date showing up primarily on your calendar app. There's no other Gregorian date, nothing. And the good thing of the calendar app is over here, it will show you left to right. So 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, it's going left to right, unlike the system date and time. Unlike the system date and time, which is going right to left. But what if you want to include the Gregorian calendar over here as a secondary calendar? It's very easy. And you just repeat what we did the first time. You go on settings, go on calendar settings, scroll down, enable alternate calendars, and instead of Hijri, select this option, the first one. You click on it. Just look at it so you know what it is. And there you go. We have 21st August 2021, and it's the 13th of Muharram 1443. So now we have reversed it the way it was the first time we did it. So the first time you had the Gregorian calendar as the main Hijri date, and you had the Hijri date as the secondary date. In my opinion, Hijri should always be the primary date because that's our beautiful calendar and it records the holy Hijri months. So we need to, in my opinion, having it this way is very, very good. So this is how I have it, basically. I have set my own PC's system date and time as a Hijri date. And in the calendar app, I have added the Gregorian date as a secondary date. So if I get any meetings or any events that I need to add to the calendar, I can simply just check on this calendar when I add it to see what the Gregorian date is. So perhaps I have a flight on the 23rd August, for example. So I could simply just click here and make the event as I wanted to. And I know that it's the 23rd and it is the 15th of Muharram. So they're both in sync in a way that I can keep track of both the dates for important events that require me to track the date. This way, I'm never left behind from tracking or keeping tabs on any events that are recorded in Gregorian dates without compromising on the Hijri calendar either, because I have that loaded up as a primary calendar. So it makes my life easy, and I would recommend it personally to every Muslim to take this approach if you're comfortable with it. If you're not, maybe you want it back to be the Gregorian date, how you want it to be, and you tried this, and maybe you're not comfortable with it, simply just go back to adjust date and time, date, time, regional formatting, and change this to whatever recommended setting you had before, and it will revert back to the Gregorian dates. This way, for me, I prefer, because now over here, even the Hijri date is showing up on the widget, and so on. And there you have it. This is the tutorial of how to have the Hijri date and time on your Windows 10 PCs, the Hijri date as a system date and time, and the Hijri calendar on your calendar application. If you found this tutorial useful and easy to follow, do share this with your friends and family. And if you have any questions regarding this or so on, do let me know down in the comments. I will get back to you as soon as I can. In the meantime, do like the video if you enjoyed it and subscribe it. Subscribe to my channel so that you can follow all the future videos I'll be uploading for other devices and other operating systems as to how we can implement more of our Islamic values and Islamic formats such as the Hijri calendar to various other platforms. So do subscribe and watch out for those. Inshallah, I'll be uploading those soon. In the meantime, take care. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.